never assume, because sometimes we have extended family looking after the baby, and the question is the baby ever being left alone? Like, not alone, I mean, with a babysitter. And sometimes parents will say yes, they have, when really the only person who's looked after them are extended family. That's not really a babysitter. Because extended family are part of their lives. We see them, they may see them every day. It's just that on today, today you've left them with grandma. Do you know what I mean? So being alone with somebody different means someone down the street. Like a stranger to the family, that's what they mean by the baby ever being left alone with somebody else. Alright? Sometimes people will answer yes, or they will answer it's debated. Exactly. Yes. And if you don't have cumin math by the time you're 18 like months, you're a terrible parent. Well, what I'm going to say too is they've done lots of studies on, you know, the parents who put the cards in front of their kids and 2 + 2 = 4 and they're doing long division by the time they're 4 years old. What those studies show is that those children are not more ahead. Like, people always think that they're going to have these brain-shield diseases if they do all of that very early on. And there's been a lot of research on that to show that that, in fact, has no influence at all.
But don't they also say that structured learning happens?
Yes, absolutely. But that's what we're saying, is to give them a different variety of experiences. And that's what the research is showing. So it's better that the children go to the zoo, to the art museum. I mean, I'm just throwing stuff off the top of my head. The art museum, go on boat, go on a ferry, go swimming. Those experiences are better than having few cars in a house. You see what I'm saying? That's better. But you do have to have some structure, right? But the other thing is, they have to have some unstructured. And unstructured just means that you can be in the house.